Hello, and welcome to this video on dividing monomials. A monomial is a mathematical expression that has only one term. So 4x, xy cubed, and 23a to the fourth are all examples of monomials. So right here especially, it doesn't quite look like this might be a monomial, but it is because these two terms are multiplied together, just like 4 and x are multiplied together. So all three of these are examples of monomials. When dividing monomials, we need to remember our exponent rules. So specifically the rule x to the m over x to the n is equal to x to the m minus n. So this means that when bases raised to exponents are divided by one another and the bases are the same, you keep the base the same and subtract the exponents. So let's start by working through a simple example. 5x over x. Remember, fraction bars always mean division. So we're dividing 5x by x. So when dividing monomials, start by dividing the coefficients by one another. It doesn't look like there's a coefficient in the denominator, but remember, any variable without a coefficient has a coefficient of 1, because 1 times anything is itself. So we can divide 5 by 1. So 5 divided by 1 is just 5. Then we move on to dividing our x terms. So we'll have x divided by x. And anything divided by itself is just 1. So this is equal to 1. Now, to get our final answer, we simply multiply these two things together. So we'll have 5 times 1, which is equal to 5. So that means that 5x divided by x is equal to 5. Let's try a slightly harder example. 12x cubed divided by 3x squared. So in this example, we're going to have to use that exponent rule that I talked about earlier. But first, we're going to start by dividing our coefficients by one another, just like we did last time. So this time we have two coefficients. We have 12 and 3. So 12 divided by 3 equals 4. Then we're going to divide our x terms by one another. So we'll have x cubed divided by x squared. So this is where the exponent rule comes into play. Remember, our bases are the same, so all we have to do is keep the base the same and subtract the exponents. So we'll have x to the 3 minus 2, which is equal to x to the 1, and anything to the first power is just itself, so this is equal to x. Finally, to get our answer, we just multiply these two things together. So this is equal to 4x. Let's try another one. 8x to the 5th y cubed divided by x squared y. First, divide the coefficients by one another. Remember, this second term has a coefficient of 1, so we'll divide 8 by 1, which is 8. Then we'll divide the x terms. Remember, the bases have to be the same for the exponent rule to work, so we'll divide the y terms by each other in the next step. So we'll do x to the 5th divided by x squared. This is equal to x to the 5 minus 2, which is x cubed. And now we move on to our y terms. So we'll have y cubed divided by y. Remember, anything without an exponent is raised to the first power. So this is equal to y to the 3 minus 1, which is equal to y squared. So our division is equal to these three things multiplied together, so 8x cubed y squared. Before we go, I want to try one last problem. This one's slightly more challenging. 5a to the 24th, b to the 7th, over 25a to the 15th, b to the 13th. Don't be confused by these a's and b's. You can treat them just like you would x's and y's. So first, we're going to divide our coefficients. So we have 5 divided by 25, which is equal to 1/5. Then we're going to divide the a terms. So we'll have a to the 24th divided by a to the 15th. So we'll have a to the 24th minus 15, which is equal to a to the 9th. Now we'll divide our b terms. So we'll have b to the 7th divided by b to the 13th, which is equal to b to the 7 minus 13, which is equal to b to the negative 6. Remember, a negative exponent tells you to put the base raised to the positive exponent in the denominator of a fraction. So this is equal to 1 over b to the 6th. Now, to get our answer, we multiply all three parts together. So we'll have 1/5 times a to the 9th times 1 over b to the 6th. And we can simplify this all into one fraction, and we'll get a to the 9th over 5b to the 6th. I hope that this video on dividing monomials was helpful. Thanks for watching, and happy studying!